It looks like the vent and anal is smaller. You guys can pause. Oh, the third, the, what was this? The one, two, three, fourth one? Yeah, he pooed all over me. Whew, you know what? I'm starting to think that I have all male Waru. These guys are not sexually dimorphic. Dimorphic meaning that you can tell by just their appearances which one is male, which one is female. Rays are a simple and easy way to tell which one is male and which one's female. You can tell from the moment they are born. Underneath a male, right by its base of its tail, it will have two things called claspers. You can see this right from its birth. If it has claspers, it's male. If it doesn't, it's female. Slightly dimorphic would be some of the vieja here. We could look at the nape of their head, which is, you know, right above their eyes. Streamlined or more flat would be female, and sometimes they'll get a black belly. This one is definitely egg-bound, ready to egg, lay eggs and looking for a mate, which she has found with him. Look at the nape of his head. Little humped out there, the belly is different, and he's sizably larger. We can also look at his dorsal, which appears to be more spiked than her. And same with the ventral fin, or the anal fin, I mean. So with those two being sexually mature, I can assume I've got a male and a female there, and at some point I'm gonna have to figure out what to do with the rest if we want them to not only lay eggs, but raise the fry, and we can enjoy that process as well. You guys know that Waru are a nostalgic fish for me. You know that I've had them spawn in my tanks before, not this one, but like 11, 12 years ago. But I never got fry because I just had females. I wanted to be able to experience the process of breeding Waru in this, like, one of the only fish that I hope breeds in this gallery. I know the rays will eventually give them what they need and they will breed. But when it comes to Waru, I need a male and a female. I know I got male and female rays, but do I have male and female Waru? So last night I'm setting up where I'm actually stripping down this tank, move the Waru from here to over there. I got the log silicone back in. I got the sump stripped down. I just put this here because I'm taking it on and off. But I am ready to start planting this tank. The Waru can't stay in it because they'll eat the plants. And I wanted to plant this tank because I think it's gonna look awesome with those standing logs and whatnot. Check it out. Of course, we'll come back to this in a future video, and the topic is the Waru. And anyways, I figured, since I already have the Waru out of the tank, I netted them, grabbed them, put them in here. Instead of just putting them in, maybe I just take a look at their private parts, figure out what they really are, and drop them in. But I wanted to capture it on camera for you guys as well, and teach you guys how to vent your fish so you can tell the sex of virtually any fish. Now, I do recommend that you do not do this at home if you want to follow these types of rules. If you don't go, what I'm trying to say is don't go netting your fish just to see this. It's stressful for them, and if you're not moving them from tank to tank or have a purpose, a real purpose other than sexing them, don't do this unless it's a breeding project. I know a lot of people, for example, and this isn't even a lot of people, this is every serious breeder. When it comes to fish like trophies, we can't, these guys are not sexually dimorphic either, not to the untrained eye. I can't go like, male, female, male. All I can do is flip them over, look at their sexual organs, and decide what they are. You take four buckets for these guys. One bucket to put them all in, two buckets for male, female, a third bucket or a fourth bucket for I'm not sure, we'll look at you again. Reason you wanna sex your fish and make sure you have a optimum male and female ratio, especially with tropius, is if you wanna establish a colony and stop the deaths and make sure they all get along, you have no choice. You also might just want to get into breeding, or maybe you want to keep all males because as they age, males sometimes look better than the females, or vice versa. Or maybe you just need an optimal ratio of male to female. Whatever the case might be, we all at some point or another wonder, is my fish male or female? Now, this isn't going to work for absolutely every fish, but it should work for most, especially cichlids. Let me first tell you where these sexual organs are. It's under the fish, I'll give you that. Draw a little fish using my art. This one's a happy fish that, okay, that, none of that matters. We have the head, the tail fin, we have the dorsal fin up here, of course pectoral, but we're really looking for this anal fin. This is the fin right after the tail. We are looking for, you guys are gonna wanna see this. We're looking right in this area, right after the anal fin, right? Right after the anal fin is a little hole, and right after that is another little hole. The first hole is the vent. The next one is the anal fin, where the waste comes from, I guess you could say. So we will be looking in this area. If you can't, if you look under your fish and you can't tell which one is the vent and which one is the anal. Just remember this, AVA. No matter which direction you hold the fish in, the anal fin, vent, anus, or anus, vent, anal fin. So AVA, no matter which direction. So even after you've located that anal fin, or the anus and the vent, what makes a male, what makes a female? Well, there's a couple of common ways that these things are gonna look. If it's a male, there's two ways it'll look. You'll have the anal hole, and then you'll have the vent. Two little holes, just like this. Sometimes it'll look like the anus is like this, and then he'll have a bit of like a little pointer, like this, kind of dark on the end. Females either look like this, or perhaps they look more like this, right? Now this depends largely on the species. If it's a male, two holes. Or a hole with a pointy little vent. Female, a hole and a bigger hole, hole and a rounded vent. There's one thing that these the males have in common is they will always be the same size, or the vent will be slightly smaller than the anus. For the female, the vent is always larger than the anus in both scenarios. If the vent isn't larger, it's rounder. Now those are the most common looking vents. There's a ton more other types, and we'll get to those in a second. That's where you guys are gonna come in. So as I was moving these guys, I set up the camera, and I was trying to get the lighting and the camera to focus and me to see, and making sure the fish wasn't out so long, so I did my best, looked. I only know what the first one is. What I think I'm going to do is I'm going to watch this footage for the first time, and not only watch it, but I want you guys to kind of guess along with me. You know what? Let's just leave it up to you guys. I know the first one that we're gonna look at is the big guy. He's 8 inches long. I know that he doesn't look 8 inches in here, but he is. I measured him last night. Everybody else is smaller. We even discovered the sex of Timmy, the little runt, the little midget, the little dwarf, the little stunted Timmy no grow. Okay, so as I'm draining the tank, I had the new tank already set up. I put some substrate in there as well as a couple logs and some Java fern just to make them feel more comfortable. I gotta do that tank, escape it properly, but testing out the Java fern to see if they'll eat it over time. I'll give them a week. If they don't eat it, I'll add a tremendous amount more. If not, we will add in some fake or silk ones because I really want the plant look with these guys. When I kept them years ago, they had tons of fake plants and they looked amazing. Okay, so the first guy I went after, oh, and by the way, Waru are not sexually dimorphic. Dimorphic meaning that you could tell the sexes apart easily. There's always something. Now some will say the males have pointed dorsals, or maybe they'll have red eyes, or different, maybe they're darker or lighter, except, but none of them are guaranteed ways. The only real guaranteed way is if we look at their private parts. So we take the first guy out and look at his spotting. Now these are like two little red dots. Wait for it to focus here. And there's a white dot, that would be his anus, and then the vent is behind it. Those are the same size. This is probably the best video. I remember the other ones I struggled with. So that's a male, a big old male. Now let's take a look at the second one. Second one, it kind of looks like the two vents are the same size as well. Although these guys aren't to breeding size yet, so their vents aren't really down. We're just taking educated guesses on what it should look like, I should say. Now we look at the third one. Okay, third one looks a lot different than the others. I wanna say female. It looks like the vent and anal is smaller. You guys can pause. Oh, the third, the one, two, three, fourth one? Yeah, he pooed all over me. Yeah, I remember that. And I was like, you know what? I'm not wiping that off. You're on your own. The fifth one, female or male? It was so difficult to see. The problem with this is you need highlighting and a magnifying glass. You really want to get in there good. I could have used a macro lens in retrospect. Here's Timmy. Look how small he is compared to the rest. I have no idea what he is. Yes, I do. He's a little boy. Little boy. But yeah, if you guys are gonna do something like this, make sure that you have good lighting and even like a reading glass or magnifying glass or somebody to help you just make sure that the fish is comfortable, because it's difficult to do everything with just two hands. You kind of need two sets of hands to do this. So high lighting, magnifying glass, and have the fish close by. Again, I don't recommend doing this unless you have a purpose for actually removing your fish from the aquarium, like for example, I'm moving the fish, or if you're under a breeding project or anything like that. I think a lot of the times though, a lot of people commit to wanting to buy a bunch of fish. Like for example, if you want to breed fish, like Wavru, for example, always start with at least six or even discus. Start with six and let them sexually mature, and chances are you will end up with a pair, but that's not always the case. I don't know, let me know what your guys' thoughts are in the comments section below, and if there is a fish out there that you know how to sex and the definition of doing it, make sure you leave that in the comments section below. This is only half of the video. The second half is down there with you guys. I'll see you guys in the next video. Oh, and I know many people are gonna say it. Yes, we do have DIY fish keeper tank tops now. Many of you guys recommended it when I was complaining about how hot it gets out here and all the sweating I do. So I took your advice and made sure that I got some tank tops. But if you guys want some, link is in the description below. If you don't want any, that's fine with me. They're serving their purpose for me.